Good evening, everyone. Welcome to this broadcast of UWA Warfare. I'm Dan Birmingham. We have some news for you about the match coming up, that being Jake Howell and CJ. Let's look at the match card graphic, if we can. This match was originally going to be the advertised Jake Howell versus Buzzsaw Billy match, but actually yesterday during training, CJ came out of nowhere and attacked Buzzsaw Billy, leaving Buzzsaw Billy a little bit banged up. He can't do the match tonight, but Howell has insisted that he face CJ tonight, one-on-one, not for anything on the line, just to avenge his fallen friend, Buzzsaw Billy.
Now we go to them. Jake Howell and CJ, the first time ever singles matchup here in UWA. No love lost between these two. As we previously said, there was an altercation between Buzzsaw Billy and CJ. This match was going to be the Jake Howell Buzzsaw Billy match we've been advertising, but unfortunately, I guess personal issues got at hand, and now CJ has taken his place. This is not for the number one contendership. It's just a fight, and now they lock up. Collar and elbow tie up. CJ shoves him away. Howell and CJ circling each other once again. Another collar and elbow. This time, Howell shoves him away. Howell's not playing around here. His friend has been messed with by this big monster, but you know, CJ. No love lost. Collar and elbow tie up once again. The third one needed a gut, but Howell's trying to get him by the leg, and he gets him by the leg. Hooking the leg, working on the ankle now. CJ just gets up. But CJ back down. Howell's not backing down. He has evolved his style to a more pure wrestling style as he crunches down on that braced knee of CJ. He's not taking any chances today. As now I think he's going to, yes, he works him into a headlock. As now he's just trying to grind the neck of CJ down, but then CJ carries him over, flips him over his own shoulder. That must have hurt Howell's back. He's a bit stunned from that. CJ's knee is still messed up. Howell's the first one up. I suppose that once your knee gets worked on, if it braced, you are a little bit more fatigued. As now Howell's trying to get CJ, but CJ with a big stomp to that I think the left knee. Working on the arm, my goodness. Is now CJ, he's going to lock in a crossface. Beautiful crossface by CJ as Howell reaches the rope. Oh my goodness. I think this match is just going no holds barred. There is an official behind the camera who is enforcing the counts. And it will count the fall if necessary. I think they're going to strike now. A kick to the and a slap to the face, and a kick to the side, slap to the shoulder. I think CJ's just playing mind games with him now. A shove by Howell. That's probably not a good idea. Shove back. Forearm, my goodness. Big forearm. But CJ's not backing down. Shoulder block. He might have made CJ too angry, putting the boots to his back. What's CJ going to go for now? I think a camel clutch. Howell slips out, maybe trying to get out. No, now he's locked in the camel clutch. Is Howell going to tap out? But CJ just lets him go. I think now CJ is just playing with Howell. He's got him now in a front face lock. DDT spikes him on his head. He spiked Howell on his head. If there's one thing that we know, a DDT is one of the most painful maneuvers in all of wrestling. As CJ now puts the knees to the side of Howell and now working on the arm he was targeting earlier. As now, you know, one thing about Howell is, yes, he does damage, but he takes his fair share of pain. Goodness, a leg DDT straight to that right ankle. CJ's not taking no chances in this one. He knows the dangers of wrestling someone like Howell, someone who is mat-based. But Howell's back up a back elbow. A big back elbow. Chops. One from CJ. One from Howell. One from CJ. Forearm to the face. kick to the side. Just more kicks. My goodness, working on that ankle he was working on. As now, just, oh my God, CJ is becoming more mat-based. He's adapting to the style of his opponent. Goodness gracious. This is unbelievable. CJ now trying to, oh my God. Catches the leg, trying to go for a DDT, sweeps the leg of Jake Howell, does CJ. CJ, I think, just taunting him now. But he tried to strike him in the face. Big strikes again. Striking still going. Caught. CJ now has him in a full Nelson. Full Nelson applied to the neck of Jake Howell, but a jawbreaker. What a smart counter from Howell. But will he keep this up? Will he keep this momentum going? Is he going to just attack viciously, or will he just be, I guess, average in his attack? We don't know. Now, as a dragon sleeper gets put on CJ. CJ trying to, I guess, try to flip out of it once again, but Howell's scouting it. He's doing his best to keep the hold on. But oh no. Smart move by CJ, whether you like it or not, attacking the eardrum of Howell. That's very important. In a match, to keep your head covered, you don't always think about it, as Howell has paid the price. Howell now on the outside of the ring. CJ looks to be in a bad way, but he sits up, and these two stare at each other. CJ's just playing mind games with him now. Stomp to the chest. CJ's just playing mind games with him, and he's not going down. Wait, he's got him by the leg. Got him by the leg. Will he go down? Howell's trying to fight it, but CJ then gets him down. Locking the leg, the ankle. He's just punching it now. No love lost. This brutality. Howell's trying to find the rope. He may be a little bit stunned. He reaches the rope. Will CJ break it? He's not. Oh, goodness. It's just, with these two, you can just feel the hatred in their bodies for one another. And just the stare down. This has all just been a hazing process. Oh my goodness. DDT from Howell now. Trying to pull him for the cover. And a kick out from CJ. This is what happens when you mess with Howell's friends. It's just stuff like this. As now, goodness gracious, God. Hammer fists to the shoulder blade. This is becoming less of a wrestling match and more of a fight for their lives. As Howell now is just slowly trying to get the big man up on his feet to go probably for that MFG cutter that he's been using lately. MFG cutter, no, against the rope. Goodness gracious, a KNK! If CJ was smart, he would cover him, but CJ's... He just collapsed from just exhaustion. He could have the match won right now, but he didn't go for the cover. That's a shame. I think he's realizing it now, but it's just too late. Howell was knocked out for a little bit there, but he's back into consciousness. It's stuff like that. DDT. A lowerly based DDT. As now, I think he's going to work on the arms again. Yes, he does. Locks him in. Howell's just kneeing on the ankle and in the foot area. He now has both those big tree trunk legs in effect. What's he going to do with them? A bridged kind of submission hold. But CJ gets him out of it. Howell on the outside of the ring once again. He knows there's too much at stake here to just take him lightly. Yes, CJ is a newer competitor, but he's one of the best newer competitors we've seen in this area, as Howell is just stalking the outside of the ring. Wait just a minute. Howell's too focused. Oh, God, a forearm right to the forehead. CJ trying to get him. He's got him. He's got the power. Oh, my goodness, a backbreaker. That was not a pretty wrestling move, folks. He just cracked his back on his knee and now an elbow. Good. And I'm attacking the ankle once again. Strike, trying to get him with the knee, a forearm straight to the forehead. And now a front face lock applied to CJ. CJ flips him out of it. CJ goes for a kick. Howell blocks the kick. Howell has the knee. Fast-paced action from these two. A second wind almost as Howell's trying to get him in some kind of wrestling hold. But CJ is just too big and probably stronger than Howell. And he's blocking it. Attacking the shoulder blade now. Attacking the abdomen as well. These two are going at it at a fever pitch. Howell gets out of that, trying to get a headlock of some kind in. My goodness gracious. He's got that arm once again. He's locked it in something, but CJ reaches the rope. Howell respectfully breaks it. That was fast-paced. Just trying to figure out what to do. Now, kick to the back.
What you get?
Howell's talking smack. He shouldn't be doing this. He should be focusing on the match itself. Will he go to the outside again? No, I think he's going to try the top rope again. He might be trying the top rope once again, but CJ gets up. He knows he's up. Howell's trying to smack him. Howell slipped. The ropes are slippery. That's now another DDT. Feigns Howell. My goodness, that could have been a big move, but the ropes were slippery. I guess he just, my goodness. That might have stunned Howell. Howell might be out. If I was CJ, I would take advantage. I would just pin him right now, but it does not look like he's going to pin him. What's he going to get him in? That's the Kimura lock. That's how he beat Disco Hefe that one time. I think Howell flips out of it and transitions into a headlock while the Kimura... Oh, and a rope break. Howell sees it, and he breaks it respectfully. That's the difference between these two competitors. CJ is ruthless. Howell is just respectful. Howell seems frustrated now. He might be thinking, what's he going to have to do? Okay, he might be setting up for it. MFG Cutter could take place right here. Trying to get the big man up. MFG Cutter! This is it! I'm calling it 1, 2, no! That wasn't it. How is that not it? After all the strikes CJ has taken... to the forehead and head area. How did that not get him? Folks, that just speaks to the will of CJ. He does not want to back down. He took his opportunity from Buzzsaw Billy to maybe steal the show. He's certainly proving why he's one of the top prospects as a forearm takes Howell's side. After this match, who knows what could happen in the Southern title picture. We don't know what can happen. It's a lot of speculation. Now, big forearms to Howell's side of the head, to the temple. That could knock a man clean out. CJ getting cocky, just pushing Howell to the outside of the ring. CJ now needing some time to breathe. Like I said, we don't know what this could mean for the Southern title division. This could spell something quite different for that picture. We don't know Buzzsaw Billy's physical state at the moment after that altercation. Who knows what this could do to that picture? As now Howell seems to be getting up faster. CJ has not gone a long match like this in his career yet. Howell has, so it could be that kind of factor. CJ under the ropes. Howell, face lock, DDT on the apron. CJ stunned, Mike. What an act. What ring awareness. He got him in the DDT. CJ's head hit the apron. CJ might go out. Why isn't Howell covering him? Wait a minute. What's Howell going to do? He's tried this twice, and it has not worked out. Anyone, he could be going for anything here. What's he going to go for? Elbow drop. Shades of his friend Buzzsaw Billy. Rolling him over. Cover time, no. Why aren't they going for the cover? This match could have ended and be won for either competitor if the cover would have been made. Now cover, 1, 2, but no, that's not it. That is definitely not it. These two, I don't think, don't even want to win anymore. They just want to beat the other to a state of unconsciousness. Howell for his friend, CJ for madness. This is, goodness gracious, we've seen wars. This one might be up there with one of the wars. Now these two are on their knees. Oh, wait, a forearm shades of the Underground Rules match. Big forearm from Howell, and they both go down. But CJ's getting back to his feet. stomps on the knee, stomps on this. He's stomping once again. But Howell's trying to get him down with a double leg takedown. But CJ's not going down. Now he just shoves him down. Good elbows to that knee. That protected knee with the brace. Howell just elbowed it to oblivion. But a kick to the side. CJ is skilled with his feet in the kick department. As now both men are down. Both men are going off of fumes. Who knows how much longer this could last? We could be here all night, for God's sake. Because the quit in these two men are just non-existent. They aren't just wrestling. They are fighting. Howell's trying to figure out now. He's trying to just pull him, trying to get him up, trying to just use all of his energy just to get him up. That could be a big mistake. He's now going to go for the cutter again. Cutter, no. Pushes him off. K&K! The second K&K of the match. And it nearly sends Howell out of the ring. And CJ's just too tired to make the cover. If he would just make the cover, he would beat Howell 1-2-3. Just as much damage as CJ is doing to Howell, he's doing it to himself by not taking the cover. Because the longer this match goes on, the more damage your body will give and the less your career may go on. And that's for both men. Goodness gracious. As now both men are down, I would say that in the next at least 5 minutes, if someone doesn't do anything, the refs might just call this off. If they just can't do anything, they have to call the match off and get these two some help. But it seems like they're getting back to consciousness. They're getting back to their feet. Or rather, their knees. I don't know where this is going to go. Pulls him in. Howell's pulled him in. He has to change his strategy up. Trying to get him back up. Oh, forearm to the shoulder. Forearm to the face from CJ. One from Howell. And, wait. Wait a minute. Wait, the ref. What's the ref doing? Why'd the bell ring? Wait a minute. I think the ref stopped the match. The ref has stopped the match. We need to see that again. It was at this moment Howell had enough scouting and they both hit each other with a forearm to the face and then they both went down. The ref has called the match. I think both men, they just can't go on anymore. If the match were to continue, a lot of damage would be done. Controversial call, but good officiating by the referee. My goodness, we've never seen an ending like this before.